Okay, so I have an example spreadsheet here that has some pretty typical data in it, I think. And when you have data like this, a lot of times you just want to put it in a different order, which would be sort, or you only want to show part of it based on some sort of criteria, and that would be filter. I'll show you sort first, and then we'll get into filtering a few items. And then keep in mind, though, you can do this two main ways. So we're going to sort and filter from the menus first. But then I'll show you a new concept that didn't really exist in previous spreadsheets, is that there's functions that can do sort and filter. And to do those, we'll go down below because they produce a new list that's based on the data in this list. All right, what you typically want to do is select the table. That's going to make this easier. And then you go to the data menu and then do sort range. There's shortcuts up here if you just want to sort the entire sheet. That's not going to know where your header is, though, so that's going to sort the header, too. Maybe that's okay. You can also just sort a range, and we already selected the range. So let's just go down to the sort range option. It's going to give you a pop-up. I think it's easier to use. There's a couple options on here that we can talk through that you're going to want to change from time to time, and they're not in those shortcuts if you do the other options on the menu. So it's telling you, look, we're looking at sorting A10 through G10, which is what you highlighted back here behind this box, but we did have a header row and I don't want that sorted. So put the check mark there. It's smart enough to take the names from that header row and put them in this drop-down list now that you told it has a header. And in this case, we're just gonna wanna sort this by region because we wanna see what happened in every region. Keep it from A to Z. And within those regions, we're gonna wanna sort it by rep name. So you click sort. It did not delete any data. It's showing you the exact same data. And you don't have to unsort it to do anything. You can leave it like this. If you notice, it does it by region alphabetically. And then within that region, it did it alphabetically by the name of the rep. That may be all you want to do, in which case all you need is sort and you're done. But if you want to take this a step further by doing some more analysis, let's select the table again. Go to data and let's try filter. So I turn the filter on and you can see at the top of every column of data, you got this upside down triangle. That's letting you know that you can filter that column, but there is no filter selected yet. If you want to see just the pencils that were sold, you want to clear all of these. I just clicked on clear and just highlight the pencils. Click OK. And that filtered out everything else in the list. Data is still there. As you can see, it goes from 3 to 9, so those rows still exist, but they're hidden from view. And one concept here that's important to know is that if I sum these, if I just do E2 to E3, then you'll get 21, which is these two being added together. But if you do the whole range, and again, you can see this goes to down to row 10, it's just hidden. It still picks up those values, 327. So they're underneath, and your formulas can pick them up if you're doing simple formulas like sum and count. But I digress. So that's one type of filter. So reset your filter. Just click select all, so all of them are in play, and then do text contains PEN. That'll pick up pencils, pen set, and pen. And then once you have a filter on, you can see that changes from an image of the upside down triangle to the filter, so you know that there's an active filter on here. So that tells you it's probably not showing everything right now. And that's true. So it still goes 6, 7, 9, 8 is hidden, 10, 11 are hidden. Now while you have a filter on, you can still do another sort, so or another filter, but let's just sort this by rep. The filter stays, it's still showing only the things that have the letters pen in them. But this is sorted, so it's not filtered, so it didn't turn into a funnel. But you could also do another filter if you wanted. Let's clear all of them and just so show Jones and Morgan. And there you go, there's two filters applied. You can apply as many filters as you want. And that's the basics of how to use sort and filter through the menu. So we're going to turn that off. There are a couple different ways to turn it off, and I'm just going to do turn off filter. Imagine that. This is the data that we started with. I want to get rid of this row 11. That's highlighted like it's part of the table. I don't like that. I'm going to right click, delete row. Okay. Now I want to show you the second main way to sort and filter, which is using functions. There's three different functions that we're going to go over. The first one is sort. So hit your equal sign, S-O-R-T, open it up with an opening parentheses, which goes on every function. And then it knows you do the parentheses and it's ready to rock. So let's give it a range. And in this case, let's do A1 to G10. As a matter of fact, let's do A2 so we don't pick up the header. A2, we want to leave the header there to G10. And let's look at the helper text again here. The second thing it wants is the sort column. So saying, what do you want me to sort it by? Let's do it by the rep. So that's sort column 3. It wants a number, not the name of the header. And we want it to be ascending, sure. So leave that as true. Now you see the next thing in the helper text is in brackets. It's saying it's not necessary, it's optional. So let's end this here. And watch, when I hit enter, it's going to write this out to the right and down below it. So start it where it has room to work. And there, sorted list. You see, got rid of the formatting. That's all right, you didn't need it. And this is all dynamic. So if you change what's in the original list, it'll change. If you change what's up here, it'll change what was outputted down here. And if you click in one of these columns, hit delete, 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 it doesn't go anywhere because it's all being driven by the sort function in A12. If you were to go in A12 and delete, it gets rid of everything. The second function that you can do is a filter. So you can guess how this is going to work. We don't have to go through it in much depth because it's the same concept. It's going to output a new list that's filtered based on how you want it to be, and it's dynamic. So if you change what's above, it'll change what's output in the filter. It may take some time to study this one. It's a little bit trickier to use filter through a function, I think. But the last one that's added is a new type of function. It's called SORTN. And this one kind of deserves its own little tutorial, I think. But what it can do is, let's give it the range, 10, is in plain English, it's saying, hey, I want the top 10 salespeople from here. I want the last 5 dates. So it can sort and return n number of values from your data set. We'll try one here. Won't get into it too much. Let's try a 3. So the top 3. And that's all you have to do. The other parameters are optional. There we go. That's the first 3 sales. If you want to learn more about these functions or about the SORTN function in particular, you can subscribe to my channel. Do lots of tutorials on little things, mostly in Google Sheets, but some other things as well. I hope you enjoyed this video. And that's all. Thanks. Bye.